My dear brothers and sisters, my first words to all of you must be words of gratitude. I am grateful to all of you for coming to this beautiful cathedral today to join me in giving thanks to God for having called me to be a bishop and for all the graces, blessings, guidance, and inspiration He has so generously given to me during the 40 years of my episcopal ministry. In June 1971, I was notified that the Holy Father had appointed me the first bishop of the new Diocese of Gaylord. It is a special privilege to be the first bishop of a new diocese. It was like the birth of a child, beginning life without any old traditions or prejudices or preconceived ideas. It was a new life, a new adventure. After 10 interesting, challenging, and happy years in the Diocese of Gaylord, the Holy Father appointed me Archbishop of Detroit in 1981. When Cardinal Dearden consecrated me a bishop in Gaylord, I never dreamed that I would succeed him 10 years later as the Archbishop of Detroit.
The solemn liturgical installation of Archbishop Szoka as our new archbishop is a rare and treasured moment in the history of this venerable church.
I do accept the pastoral care of the people of God in the Archdiocese of Detroit. I resolve to serve faithfully the church of this archdiocese.
There were challenging, exciting, wonderful years. The joys and the satisfaction far outweighed the difficulties and problems. Then in 1990, Pope John Paul II asked me to come to Rome to work for the Holy See. I spent the next 18 years in Rome, serving in various assignments. At the age of 80, I was relieved of all my various responsibilities for the Holy See and returned here to the Archdiocese of Detroit in the year 2008. For a bishop to fulfill all his responsibilities has never been easy. In our time today, I believe it is especially difficult. We live in a very different society, a society that has become very materialistic and very secular. It is not easy today to be a good Catholic Christian. We are torn in all directions by a society in which many have lost their bearings. But we certainly can remain friends of God with His grace and help, with our fidelity to prayer and to the sacraments. Bishops and priests are called to take the lead, to minister to God's people, even though life for them is not easy or without temptation. But they will succeed in their ministry, because God has called them and has made them His friends. Finally, the words that echo in my heart today as I look upon all of you are the words of our Blessed Mother. She said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for He has looked with favor on His lowly servant. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is His name." God bless you, and amen.